So today we will talk about the citric acid cycle or the Krebs cycle or tricarboxylic acid cycle. Citric acid cycle or TCA cycle or Krebs cycle was discovered by Hans A. Krebs, a German born British biochemist who received the Nobel Prize in 1953. This cycle occurs in the matrix of mitochondria and cytosol in prokaryotes. The whole cycle is explained in this figure, and the net result of citric acid cycle is that for each acetyl group entering the cycle as acetyl coenzyme A, two molecules of CO2 are produced. You can see that one molecule of CO2 is produced in pyruvic acid dehydrogenation. So when we talk about the citric acid cycle, we first understand what is pyruvic oxidation. So in the presence of oxygen, the further oxidation of pyruvate occurs in the mitochondrial matrix or cytosol in case of prokaryotes. In the mitochondrial matrix, the pyruvate first oxidizes into acetyl coenzyme A. So this reaction, that is the formation of acetyl coenzyme A from pyruvic acid, this conversion of pyruvate to acetyl coenzyme A catalyzed by highly organized multi-enzyme pyruvate dehydrogenase complex. It is an oxidative decarboxylation process. In the overall reaction, the carboxyl group of pyruvate is lost as CO2, while the remaining two carbons form the acetyl moiety of acetyl coenzyme A. The reaction is highly exergonic and essentially irreversible in vivo. It is highly exergonic and essentially irreversible in vivo. So the oxidation of pyruvate to acetyl coenzyme A involves the coenzymes thiamine pyrophosphate TPP, lipoic acid, FAD, NAD plus and coenzyme A. So these all coenzymes, they act in association with all enzymes in the pyruvate dehydrogenase complex. So when we talk about the citric acid cycle, as we all know that for each acetyl group entering the cycle as acetyl coenzyme A, two molecules of CO2 are produced. Now we come to the first step. The first step is the formation of citric acid, and that is why the cycle is known as citric acid cycle. The citric acid cycle begins with the condensation of an oxaloacetate, 4-carbon unit, and the acetyl group of acetyl coenzyme A, 2-carbon unit. Oxaloacetate reacts with acetyl coenzyme A and water to yield citrate. You can see here that the oxaloacetate reacts with acetyl coenzyme A and water to form citrate or citric acid. This reaction, which is an aldol condensation reaction, it is an aldol condensation followed by a hydrolysis, is catalyzed by citrate synthase. The first enzyme is citrate synthase. Citrate synthase is the enzyme which forms the catalysis of citric acid. Now you will see the step 2A and 2B. In 2A, water is removed, and in 2B, water is again moved in the reaction. This is an isomerization reaction in which water is first removed and then added back, moves the hydroxyl group from one carbon atom to its neighbor. The enzyme catalyzing this step, aconitase, non-heme iron protein, is the target site for the toxic compound fluoroacetate. So this reaction, 2A and 2B, is actually the formation of isocitric acid, in which here you see the formation of isocitrate. You can also see in the center that the first reaction is condensation, 2A is dehydration, 2B is hydration. Third and fourth, now the step third, this isocitric acid, now you will be able to see that isocitric acid is oxidized and decarboxylated to alpha ketoglutarate. In the first of four oxidation steps in the cycle, the carbon carrying the hydroxyl group is converted to a carbonyl group. The immediate product is unstable, that is oxalosuccinic acid, which is unstable and losing CO2 while still bound to the enzyme. The oxidative decarboxylation of isocitrate is catalyzed by isocitrate dehydrogenase. So you will see that the isocitric acid forms oxalosuccinic acid, which is not mentioned here, and the oxalosuccinic acid, by removing carboxide, forms alpha-ketoglutarate or alpha-ketoglutaric acid. Now the fourth reaction is the second oxidative decarboxylation reaction. Results in the formation of succinyl coenzyme A from alpha-ketoglutarate. Now you will see that from alpha-ketoglutarate, succinyl coenzyme is formed and there is release of CO2 coupled with NADH, formation of NADH. And a high energy thioester compound, both to bond to enzyme A. Now, step 5 is the cleavage of the thioester bond of succinyl coenzyme A is coupled with the phosphorylation of NADP or AGTP. This reaction 5 is called substrate level phosphorylation. You will see that from succinyl coenzyme A, succinate is formed with the release of 1-ATP. This step is catalyzed by succinyl coenzyme synthetase, succinic thiokinase. ATP and GTP are energetically equivalent. This is the only step in the citric acid cycle that directly yields a compound with high phosphoryl transfer potential through a substrate level phosphorylation. So animal cells have two isoenzymes of succinyl coenzyme A synthetase, one specific for ADP and the other for GTP. The GTP formed by succinyl coenzyme A synthetase can donate its terminal phosphoryl group to ADP to form ATP in a reversible reaction catalyzed by nucleoside diphosphate kinase. Whenever there is formation of ATP directly, the enzyme used is kinase. In the cells of plants, bacteria, and some animal tissues, an ATP molecule forms directly by substrate-level phosphorylation. Substrate-level phosphorylation. Now in the step 6, in the third oxidation step in the cycle, FAD removes two hydrogen atoms from succinate. The enzyme catalyzing this step, succinate dehydrogenase. You will see that succinate dehydrogenase forms fumarate. In the seventh step, the addition of water to fumarate places a hydroxyl group next to a carbonyl carbon. In step 8, in the last of four oxidation step in the cycle, the carbon carrying the hydroxyl group is converted to a carbonyl group, regenerating the oxaloacetate needed for step 1. NAD plus linked malate dehydrogenase catalyzes the oxidation of malate to oxaloacetate. So this is the complete reaction of Krebs cycle, in which 3 NADH, 1 FADH2, 1 ATP are formed. So this cycle is actually regulated at its 3 strongly exergonic steps, catalyzed by enzyme saturate synthase, isosaturate dehydrogenase, and alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. The regulatory enzymes of the citric cycle seem to control flux primarily by 3 simple mechanisms: substrate availability, product inhibition, and allosteric feedback inhibition of the enzyme. So this is actually the amphibolic reaction, and citric acid cycle intermediates are used in biosynthetic pathways as well. So the anabolic nature of the citric acid cycle has raised the question of how the level of intermediates can be replenished when certain intermediates are removed from anabolic purpose. Kornberg has proposed the term anaplerotic for these replenishing or filling up reactions. So this is an anaplerotic reaction, in which the compound which has been lost during the cycle is being replenished or filling up. So this is cycle of Krebs cycle or TCA or second step in respiration. So here you will see the first reaction is condensation, in which citric acid is formed. Second reaction is dehydration, in which water is removed. Third reaction is hydration, in which water is added back. Fourth reaction is oxidative decarboxylation, in which alpha-ketoglutaric acid is formed. Next step is oxidative decarboxylation, in which CO2 is removed. Next step is very important, which is phosphorylation, in which direct 1 ATP is formed. Next step is dehydrogenation, in which hydrogen is removed. Next one is hydration, in which hydrogen is added to form fumarate, to form malic acid from fumaric acid. And the last one is dehydrogenation, in which once again NAD is changed into NADH2 and 3 ATPs are formed. So this is the complete cycle of Krebs cycle, including pyruvic acid dehydrogenation or pyruvic acid oxidation. So this Krebs cycle is very important, as this is the basis of the formation of ATP, in which after glycolysis the pyruvic acid is oxidized by formation of 3 ATP. So in whole Krebs cycle, including pyruvic acid oxidation, the 15 ATPs are formed, as there was formation of 2 pyruvic acid molecule. 1 pyruvic acid molecule is changed into forms 15 ATP, so 2 ATP molecule forms 30 ATP molecules. 2 plus 6, that is 8 ATPs are synthesized in glycolysis, so total 38 ATPs are formed from one complete oxidation of glucose. This is how the ATPs are formed in respiration. So I do hope that you would have been understood the cycle, the Krebs cycle or TCA cycle. I hope you have all got known about this cycle, this step. And tomorrow I will tell you about the electron transport system. Thank you. Bye-bye.